7:36 right now, and New Year's Eve, just a few days away. And for many of us, bringing in the new year just isn't complete without sashimi. Dallis Ontiveros is live at the fish auction with more on what kind of prices we can expect this week. Morning, Dallis.
Good morning, Ross. That's right. It's a tasty tradition just a few days away. And still hanging out with us on Wake Up Today, we have Mike Goto, who's a United Fishing Agency auction manager. Aloha, good morning.
Morning, Doc.
And the sun has finally came up. We've been waiting all day for it, but of course, the working is still happening here. But if you could tell us a little bit of what we're seeing right behind us.
So right now, we're in the middle of unloading our seventh and second to the last longline vessel of the day, the fishing vessel Sylvia. Right now, they're unloading basically everything that they've caught in their trip up until this point. And again, we're taking up to 120,000 pounds of fish today, which is, you know, usually what we do during this time of year. But you know, we have to see how the market's going to reflect on that. Usually there's a very, very high demand, but you know, due to the COVID conditions, closure of restaurants, limited tourism, you know, it's not as prosperous a market as it usually is.
And that has made prices lower at this point, right, for anyone who missed out earlier?
Correct. I mean, you're monitoring it day by day, even boat by boat, to see what's going to happen. You know, the vendors who come and purchase through the auction, they're really, taking their orders as they come, you know, rather than having, you know, many, many pre-orders as they usually do. So, again, we're just really looking at it at a case-by-case basis.
Nice. And, you know, you're here every day to see the hard work done nonstop and to see the size of these fish that come in. I mean, what goes on through your head, or what always surprises you at the end of the day?
I mean, it's as repetitive and as this business is, you know, it's always great to see, you know, when there are higher spikes in demand for Hawaii seafood, you know, than there ever has been in the past. I think the reputation of our fleet, the way that the fishing vessels, you know, handle their the regulations that are set forth, you know, and really put them above, you know, I think any other fishery in the world. I think that's starting to reflect on the market. And because, you know, the Hawaii brand itself is attractive, but, you know, to back that up with substance, to have actual science back us up, and the regulatory regime as well, you know, it's actually great to see that people are beginning to appreciate more and more, you know, the value that this fleet has with regard to bringing fresh seafood into the state.
Absolutely, truly working for Hawaii. And I just love to see the process, you know, step by step, different parts of where we're at right now. So Mike is still gonna be hanging out with us. Of course, he's providing us great insight of what the fishing industry has gone through this year. But like he mentioned, you know, there's a lot of things to consider, and sounds like everything's very fluid right now. But of course, if you want some more details of what to expect and how things are going with the fishing industry, you can check our website at khon2.com, where you can read the latest coverage. Reporting from the scene here, Dallis Ontiveros, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.
Thank you very much, Dallis.